Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I wanted to film my everyday makeup routine. So first, I'm going to go ahead and start off by applying a lip balm. This is the one that I'm using at the moment. Then I'm going to go ahead and start by priming my face. I'm using the Hangover RX primer so my makeup doesn't go anywhere. It's great for dry skin, which is why I'm using it today. And I'm also using the Smashbox Pore Filler Primer. If you want to opt out for a cruelty-free brand, I recommend the NYX one. That is the only one that I know of at the moment. For a base or foundation, basically I wanted to go for something more softer. I don't like wearing foundation on an everyday basis, so I usually go in with a BB cream or a CC cream. This is my favorite one from Marcel. It is the glowing one that I got in one of my subscription boxes, and I'm so sorry, I have no idea what happened, but I did apply concealer to my under eye area, and what I did was I applied the It's Under Eye Bye Bye Concealer, that one, in the shade Light. Next, I'm just gonna go ahead and set everything, including my eye, because I will not be applying a lot of eyeshadow, so I wanted something there. And I'm just using the NYX Light Blotting Powder underneath the eye, and everywhere else I am setting it with a foundation powder. I really do need to go out and purchase more foundation powders, because everything that I have just seems to be super light, and I don't like mixing my personal stuff with my professional stuff. So next, I'm going to go ahead and bronze up the skin, and I'm using an angled brush. I'm only using the bottom half of the brush, as you saw, whenever I'm picking it up, so that it is easier to blend out, and I'm getting it in the hollows of my cheeks. I don't like to contour my forehead because it's already small, but I do want to put product there so that everything looks cohesive. I'm going to contour with the Too Faced Medium Chocolate Soleil bronzer, as it says, and I'm contouring with it just because it is darker, and I think that it helps bring out the warmth in my skin. And with any leftover product, I'm going to go ahead and buff it into the crease of my eyes, and also just shape my nose a little bit more so that it's no longer hidden from the concealer and the BB cream that I used. I normally like to keep my makeup on the light side. I don't like too many steps. If it takes too many steps to do it, I just won't do it at all. So you'll notice that I kind of keep the same thing going on for my makeup tutorials, or at least the foundation part. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up any messiness that I may have caused with my under eye powder brush that I used before. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight, and I'm going to use the Laura Geller highlighter in Gilded Honey, and I'm just going to place it with my finger so that I get the most pigmentation, and then blend it out with a fluffier brush. You can definitely build it up, use less, whatever you want to do, and then I'm going to go ahead and set my face with the Kula setting spray. I'm going to use this Girlactic eyeliner. It is definitely not my favorite. I freaking hate it. I always have to squeeze the product out on my hand and then dip into it. That way I can go ahead and create the wing. Otherwise it just dries up on me. But the base, like the main look of my everyday makeup look, is winged eyeliner. I've been doing this since I was a junior in high school, and it goes with everything you can think of. So I like to do it thinner on the inner corner, thicker on the outer corner. And since I don't like applying mascara because my eyelashes are too curly, the ends of them, they curl up, and I just hate it so much. I've just been putting on false eyelashes, so I don't have to worry about clumping up all the mascara. And I honestly have to purchase some right now. Whenever I want to film with my everyday makeup, I do like to opt out for false eyelashes, which is what you see me doing here. And I like to do that just so that you can see my eyes a little bit more, because they kind of tend to look a little bit squinty when I'm wearing, or when I'm using my soft boxes. So I'm just going to go ahead and go in with this Marcel Curling Mascara. I really, really do love this. If you want a cruelty-free mascara, I recommend this. It is amazing. And all I'm doing is just kind of blending my lashes with the false lashes and then coating the bottom lashes. So now I'm just making sure I have all the lip gloss or all the lip balm off. And then I'm going to go ahead and start lining in my lips. I'm using the Giordano Tawny. However, I do plan on changing it to something that is a little bit more softer and closer to my lip tone. My lip tone? Yeah, right? Lip tone, lip color. But this is the closest thing that I have. So I'm filling in the entire thing. And then I'm going to go ahead and go in with any remainder of the concealer that I have around the tube and pat it in and blot it into my lips just so that it complements me more since it is my skin tone concealer, if you get what I'm saying. It won't look too pale. Then I'm going to go in with this Noya lip gloss and apply it only in the center of my lips. I got this in BoxyCharm. I love it. It is cruelty-free and it claims to be organic and somewhat vegan. But I really do love applying this only in the center of my lips. I think it makes me look so fresh. Makes me look youthful. I love it. But of course, you guys know that I always do rock a bold lip. So I wanted to go ahead and show you guys my favorite soft lip. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And remember that I love you all. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.